What's up, guys? Welcome back to Dark Souls. Comfy Time Gamer here. We are back down at the bottom of the Great Hollow. Didn't want to make you have to watch me come all the way back down here. This time being a little bit more, safer with the mushroom guys. These guys hit fucking hard. God damn it. Get off me. But rest assured, we are almost out of here. And to be honest with you, this whole area had me a little pissed off. I wasn't having a fun time playing it until I got out to where it leads out to. And it is, quite frankly, awesome. And to think that it's a completely hidden area is pretty cool, if I'm being honest, that they put that much work into it. Rather, they put that much work into an area that's hidden behind a double illusory wall. I never would have found that. Not in a million years. Because if I kept playing long enough, I'm sure I might find it, but it's very well hidden. People are just so out of that mindset of games these days. Looking for secrets. Although you find out fairly quickly in Dark Souls that exploration is rewarded. Extremely rewarded. And this area is one hell of a reward. It's gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous. The music is just fucking killer, man. I mean, it is great. I was actually thinking this was going to be like a boss fight or something, and I was like, God damn it. No, there's no bonfire down here. It's like, fuck. Awesome. Probably one of the most, I guess you could say it's really plain, because I mean, there's, you got the water, you got the land, and then the trees. It's so simple, but, to me, this area is just one of the most beautiful spots in the game thus far. It's just, I don't know, just is. I just really, really like it. This music kicks in. Listen to that shit, man. It's just this very primal, oh shit, Hydra. Did spot that bonfire though. We are gonna make a beeline for that, and we're gonna hit that before we do anything else. Anything else? I'm gonna kindle it now. We'll see if we even need to. I'm not so sure I necessarily want to go human here anyway. I haven't paid off Oswald for the Gwendolyn betrayal yet. So, I'm in the book. So you got this Hydra chilling over here. I'm just kind of looking for treasures, hidden treasures. Which I'm thinking, okay, well, this isn't the first time we've seen one of these, but God, I just love all these arch trees in the background, and now it's occurring to me that when we were coming down that walkway before we hit Paladin Leroy, we were looking down onto this, except we were looking down onto the cloud cover that's above us. We're now actually, I believe, that we're now actually below that. So we're at a very low point of these, this area of very old arch trees. And actually, the name of the area didn't really occur to me till a little bit later in the part. I'll talk about my thoughts on that when we get to it. But as I'm playing right now, I was just thinking that this was sand that we're walking on, and I don't think it is sand, to be honest with you. I think it's something else, something far more ancient and nefarious. Lots of dragon stuff down here. Kind of want to scoot by this Hydra for now, but he is actually moving. He's moved closer. Somebody remind me, those are, correct me if I'm wrong, that the Hydra, what the Hydra shoots is, it's not magic, it's all physical. It's an all physical attack. Correct me if I'm wrong. Yeah, fuck that Hydra for now. Here's a very interesting environmental piece. It appears to be the petrified. I'll get a better look at it in a little bit. But it looks like it's the petrified remains of a dragon's. A dragon's skull. Here's why I find out how tough these fucking clams are. No, what are you doing? Get out of there. Run away. I don't know, actually, if that's a carving or if that's supposed to be an actual skull or not. Either way, it makes a nice spot to start attacking the heads on this Hydra from range. So nice not having that Ring of Favor on. I mean, it really is. I love being able to quickly swap between different rings for different situations. Still keep my Havels on. That one's always hitting them. There we go. Get a real range reduction. You get a range penalty when you're using the large arrows. The Hawk Ring really offsets that. I mean, not to an infinite amount of distance, but it really does. It really does help. Find a nice spot over here where I can just pump arrows. There we go. Now we're putting in some work. We got left two heads. There we go. It's down. It gives us two dragon scales for our effort. So the arch tree we came down, pretty big. Here's where I found out these clams drop twinkling titanite, so could actually come down here to farm for that instead of paying the 8,000 souls or whatever to the giant blacksmith. I think they're 8,000. They're not exactly cheap. Another dragon scale. We'll hit that on our way back. Look at the size of that fucker. Compared to the one that we came down in, these trees are just massive. And then this one over here, shit. More basilisks, not a good sign. Mushroom dudes. Nope. Not right now. We'll come back. Oh, I almost fell. You know, I do like this paladin chest piece, but I gotta say, the fact that I couldn't find a high-res version of it is really sort of annoying. Going the wrong way, stupid. So I don't know if I'm actually gonna keep using it. It just doesn't look as, I mean, I like it, but it's just, I don't know, it's just not as cool as my elite knight armor. But I'll wear it for a little bit. Clams, man. I mean, there we go. Thinking with a decent humanity and the gold servant ring, you could probably rack up some titanite down here. Just keep farming from the bonfire, run over, kill the clams, rinse, repeat. If I need to upgrade anything else with the titanite, I'll probably start doing that. I gotta say, that's not a Drake fucker. Coming down here, this part right here, makes it all worth it. I am like, what the fuck? This ain't no Drake. This ain't no wyvern. This, my friends, is a fucking dragon. Like a real dragon. Like an OG dragon. Tri-tail. Everlasting dragon. Eternal as fuck. To me, to be honest with you, this thing was more fucking godlike than running into Gwendolyn or Guinevere. I mean, this thing We've now literally met the oldest. This is the oldest thing in the fucking Dark Souls world right now for us. I mean, probably second place is the Primordial Serpents. Primordial meaning, you know, the beginning of time and space. These motherfuckers were here before that, before the first flame. Gotta have some respect for that. Small head though, expecting something bigger. Let's go ahead and go take a couple whacks at his tail though. Which actually wouldn't even occur to me if I wouldn't have seen that player sign. I'm still kind of worried about it though, because, yeah, here we go. Let's go ahead and take a rest there, just in case. And you get the Dragon Greatsword. This guy could care fucking less. Doesn't give a shit, dude. How he survived, or it's not even a he, I don't think. How it survived Gwyn's war on the dragons, I don't know. But I'm not really into the dragon weapons, but this thing is pretty cool looking. If I can find it. Fuck is it? It's gotta be. Dragon Greatsword. 390 base takes a 50 minimum strength. This sword, one of the rare dragon weapons, came from the tail of the Stone Dragon of Ash Lake, descendant of the ancient dragons. Its great mystical power will be unleashed when wielded in two hands. Stone Dragon, man. OG as fuck. Look at this fucking sword. It's crazy. It's no wonder that there's so much so many dragon scales to be found here. And it leads right into my you know, after meeting this dragon and then thinking to myself, oh, we're at Ash Lake, it occurs to me this could quite possibly be one of the battlefields of Gwyn and his knights and the dragons. This is probably not sand that we are walking on. This is probably literally ash from the burned arch trees that the Witch of Izalith and her chaos witches burned. It could be remains of dragons that were destroyed. That combined with, I mean, that knowledge combined with just the whole atmosphere, the music, it's a very somber, it's a very ancient, primordial place. So, I give respect to that. It's not blasphemous. Don't accuse me of that. Still serve Gwyn, but you gotta give respect to when respect's due. And this motherfucker here has been around for a very, very long time. When you run into somebody that's older than the god that you worship, yeah, better go ahead and give yourself, drop down and give a little prostration for that. I'll give it up for the Everlasting Dragon. Not interested in joining the Covenant, but very, very cool. Well worth coming down here. And just a very special area. I can't believe that it's so well hidden. I don't know how long it took for somebody to find this the first time before there were player messages. Probably somebody accidentally rolling into that, to pick up that plank, rolling into that chest and kicking off the illusory wall, but man, a lot of detail put into this area that the developers are knowing full well that most of their player base isn't even going to come down here. That's fucking balls, man. I mean, that's just shit that developers don't do anymore. You can't even call this area an Easter egg. I mean, it's too big. It's too ornate. I don't know. Super, super cool. It only increases my respect for FromSoft and the way they like to put out a game. It's just simply amazing. I need to stop gushing over it. It's just really, really cool. But unfortunately, we're out of time. I promise, guys, in the next part, we're going to get the fuck out of here. And we're actually going to be, I think I'm going to be heading off to the Duke's Archives to explore that area next. We'll save Izalith for the last. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. As always, feel free to like, subscribe, comment, and fucking praise it, man. Great area. Thank you to the YouTube commenter who suggested it. I was a little pissed off at you on my way down through the hollow tree, but it was well worth the trip, man. Thanks a lot.